Good morning. I would like to welcome each of you to the Altoona Christian Church, both in person and virtual. Today, Pastor Lisa is on vacation, and it is Laity Sunday. Laity Sunday is a Sunday in which the lay people of the congregation lead the service. And today, on this Sunday, the people that are leading the service are your elders: John Champion, Cheryl Laird Rist, Bob Robita, Wayne Patchen, Mary Heinrich, and myself. A couple housekeeping items. We are a disciples of church, and therefore we have open communion, where all are welcomed at God's table. The communion cup and bread is on the table in the narthex, and there are plastic baggies in each pew, and we ask you to put your cup in that after partaking it. If you don't pick up your communion, please do so during our praise hymn. Last, each of you received an index card. Should be a 5x7 index card. If you did not, there are more index cards on the table back there. So please get one, because I will be talking about it later on in the service. And so I ask that you, everybody, have one. Let us stand and sing our praise hymn. I welcome each of you and would ask that you welcome each other with a wave, an elbow bump, and a turn around to the camera in the back of the church to welcome friends who are worshiping with us virtually. Welcome. Peace of Christ. There, peace of Christ be with you all.
And with you.
Thank you. Please be seated.
Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Good morning. Please join me in the call to worship. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Tell of God's salvation from day to day.
Declare God's glory among the nation, the Creator's marvelous works among all the peoples.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised.
Amen. Join me in prayer. Lord, be with us this Laity Sunday as we, your elders, lead you to celebrate, to pray with, to sing for, and be with your word throughout this week. Amen.
Thank you.
Now is the time for our joys and concerns. Beginning with joys, we give thanks for the relaxation of the restrictions within the church, that we may become more like what we were prior to the pandemic. Yes. Thanks be to God. Prayers and joys for the youth and teachers completing the school year, and that they may have a fun summer and travel in safety. Thanks be to God. We are pleased to celebrate with the LGBTQ Pride Month is in June. Also in June is the Cancer Awareness Month. And with that, our prayers of concerns for Doug Casey with the return of cancer. Sorry. Okay. Clear the ice. Prayers for Sue Hines, sister of Anna Hines, who's facing ongoing health issues. Prayers for Anna, with her being the caregiver for Sue. Lord, hear our prayers. Prayers for Norma Stewart, who fell and broke her wrist. Scott shared the surgeon was content with the alignment in her wrist bones and will keep her in a cast for at least 2 weeks. Lord, hear our prayers. Oh. Prayers for Erland, husband of Mary Heinrich, who was working in their garage and cut his hand. He will be undergoing surgery this Thursday to repair tendon damage, but needs to be cleared from his heart doctor. Lord, hear our prayers. Continued prayers for those we are not mentioning or have special concerns that they have not brought to our attention. Lord, hear our prayers. Continued prayers for our church and the members of the transition team with Pastor Lisa as we continue to work for the good of our church. Lord, hear our prayers. Would you please join me in our Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning. Our first reading this morning is from Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verses 1 to 12. For everything there is a reason and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what was planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time from refraining from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. What gain have the workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he has put a sense of past and future into their minds. Yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. I know that there is nothing better for them than to be happy and enjoy themselves as long as they live. Thus ends our first reading. Let us pray. Holy One, thank you for bringing us to this place on this day and at this time. We realize in our own lives that there is a time for everything, and today is a time to worship, to give praise and thanks, and to ask for forgiveness. Be with us now, Lord, as we go through the rest of this service. Let our minds and our hearts and our actions be all done in your holy name. Amen.
The second reading of scripture is from the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verses 31 to 40. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit at the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people from one another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep at his right hand, and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, "Come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?" And the king will answer them, "Truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me." I would like to pray the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make us the instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O divine master, grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. And it is in dying, that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
My scripture this morning is from the it's the entire 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians, with a brief introduction at the end of chapter 12. But strive for the greater gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not imitable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part, but when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but when we'll see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been. I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now, faith, hope, and love abide, these three. And the greatest of these is love. Loving God, we see how you have great love for all of humankind. God, send your Spirit into our hearts that we may know our love for all people, for those with differences from us, be they in distance, in appearance, in customs, and in opinions. We know that we wish to know that we will love everyone, even those different from us, that we can respect and love Amen.
Thank you. Here is the table of the Lord. We are gathered to his supper, a taste of things eternal. Come when you are fearful, to be made new in love. Come when you are doubtful, to be made strong in faith. Come when you are regretful, and to be made whole. Come, old and young, there is room for all.
The beginning, we. What? I'm on. We are all disciples of Christ, and as disciples, we are invited to this table, not some, but all. So remember, as you come to this table, Christ has called us in love and in faith and in grace. And so remember On the night before Jesus died, he was with his apostles celebrating the Passover. But on that night, he did something he had not done before. While they were eating, Jesus took a piece of bread. He blessed it, and he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body given for you." Supper was over. He took a cup some say was set aside for the prophet Elijah's return. But he took that cup, he blessed it, and gave thanks for it, and gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It is shed for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Each time you do this, remember me."
May we pray. Just as these pieces of bread come from a single loaf, one God in three persons, so we are who are many become people in your love. Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man, we thank you for the one bread, one body, one Lord of all, whose presence we experience and whose sacrifice we remember with thanksgiving at this table. There is one cup of blessing which we bless, O God, from whom all blessings flow, and it is the cup of the new covenant made possible in Christ's blood. Continue to push us for your inclusive love in Jesus Christ, so that we will make every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. Remind us every time that we gather at this table, where we are made one by your love, that the world is looking at our unity and making decisions about the truth of the gospel of what is seen. May they see Christ. Amen.
Our offering service this morning. Put your offering in the offering plate as you leave, or send it by mail, or pay online. You can find a link to online payments in this email, or in the email we send out every Thursday called Staying Connected. Please give generously. Generous Lord, we wish to be generous to further your work here on earth. Give us hearts that wish to help others. In Christ's name, amen.
Please be seated. Our announcements for this morning, each of us clean our homes and clean and spruce up our homes on a regular basis. We also need to clean up and spruce our church. We will be having a work day next Saturday again, June 12th from 9 to noon. I strongly encourage you to come for fun and fellowship. LaCosta, who is operating our technology, is in search of people to assist running the soundboard. Please see her after the service if you are interested. No technology is experience. Yes, we have Eva helping today. No technology experience is needed, so we're all able to do this. There you go. If a 10-year-old can do it, we can do it too. Scout Troop 383 is having a garage sale June 5th at 1103 Scenic View Boulevard in Altoona from 8 to 3. This is a fundraiser for their Colorado trip, summer camping trip. Wednesday night, live with the pastor, Lisa, will resume this week at 7. If you would like a link to the Bible study, please email Pastor Lisa. Any other announcements? Nick, did I hear this morning, did you get your scholarship to go overseas? For you what? Okay. Nick is, our soloist this morning, is applying to go to Europe, is that correct? And to be in performance, but is in applying to a school over there. So kind of exciting to watch. Everybody get a card? Everybody get a card? Okay, good. My little ditty is called entitled Casting Stones. I want to begin with the scripture Casting Stones, coming from John 8, 1 through 7. Then each of them went home, while Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. Early in the morning, he came to the temple. All the people came to him, and he sat down and began to teach them. The scribes and the Pharisees brought a woman who had been caught in adultery, and making her stand before all of them, they said to them, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. Now in the law of Moses commanded us to stone such a woman. Now what do you say?" They said this to test him, so that they might have some charge to bring against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. When they kept on questioning him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let anyone among you who is without sin be the first to throw the stone at her." And once again he bent down and wrote on the ground. When they heard it, they went away one by one, beginning with the elders. The message, and it's not really a message, it's a concern that I want to share. It's going to be a bit different, but I have a strong need to share it. Today I'm down on the floor versus the pulpit, because this message is much for me as it is for that I want to share it. Please understand I'm not pointing fingers, because you remember when you point a finger, one goes out, but three come back. So it's pointing at me too. In this scripture, we read about casting stones. What is casting a stone? I see it somewhat like baggage. Suitcases that we take on a trip, a baggage hung over our shoulder, or hung on our back as we go to the store shopping. Baggage can also be grudges that we carry with us for a lifetime. This morning, when I refer to baggage or casting stones, I am referring to church baggage. Our church baggage can be what we have inherited through life as a Christian and choose to carry on with us as we move from year to year or minister to minister. Some of our baggage is what is handed to us by others before we came to join Altoona Christian Church. Some we pack on our own, such as a hurt because someone said something we didn't like in a conversation, whether it be in a committee meeting, parking lot talk, working on a project together, or board meeting or committee's decision that didn't go like we thought it should. A committee we wanted to be on, but were not asked to be a part of that chairperson. God forbid if we didn't volunteer. Now is the time to let go of this church baggage or the old ways we are done and move on to the future. Many of us carry heavy baggage from years of mistakes, hurt, pain, bad choices that we made. That is the same for us at Altoona Christian Church. But our faith and our trust in Jesus allows us to unpack and learn and move on with God's help. I pray that each of you participated in Pie with a Pastor and or completed the cards handed out by the transition team and wrote on those cards topics, issues that will help Pastor Lisa together with the transition team to take the necessary steps along the way to help us heal. Yes, we are in a growing or pain place now, but with God's healing and listening to him, we can and will make it. I ask that you take the card that was given you at the beginning of the service and, one, write a pledge between you and God on that card of what you plan to do to move on. And, or, two, write a grudge or issue you have been holding on to and are truly willing to let it go so that it is not talked about or brought up again. I will have a shredder in the Northex for you to just stick your card in after you've written it. Just stick your card in and it's going to be shredded right away. I'm not seeing it, nor is anybody else. No one will ever see these that you wrote, what you wrote on the card, as it's a pledge between you, God, and Altoona Christian Church. And that we are willing to move on. And that we will work together as a team to grow our church. Remember, team, T-E-A-M, can stand for together. Together, everyone achieves more. And as Altoona Christian Church, I pray that you are willing to work together to achieve more and for our church to grow. I challenge us as a church family to leave the past behind and move confidently into the future of Altoona Christian Church, showing love, respect, kindness to each other. Each of us are valued, appreciated, and a child of God. In closing, I share a quote I found. Judas had the best pastor, the best leader, the best advisor, the best counselor, yet he failed. The problem is not the leadership or the church you go to. If your attitude or character doesn't change or your heart doesn't transform, you'll always be the same. Amen. Join me in our closing prayer. May God take your hands and work through them. Take your lips and speak through them. Take your minds and think through them. Take your hearts and set them on fire with love, the power of Christ who goes with you. Amen. And our benediction, go out in the world in peace. Whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of Jesus, Lord Jesus, giving thanks in God through him. Amen.